Hi all, and welcome to today's webinar, How to Embed Analytics, Methods and Examples. My name is Teresa Sajdlová, and I am a content creator at GoodData.
For those who are not familiar with GoodData, our company delivers embedded analytics at scale, helping more than 140,000 companies to achieve their analytics goals and ultimately grow their business.
Before we start, let me briefly go over some webinar logistics. All attendees are muted upon entry. If you have any questions, please feel free to use the Zoom Q&A box and my colleagues will answer them for you right away. And lastly, a follow-up email with the webinar recording will be sent to all participants in case you would like to return to any of the topics discussed or share with a colleague. Today, we are going to focus on embedded analytics. What is it and how it is connected to data culture? What are the benefits of embedding? And more specifically, what are the types of embedding available and the use cases that best suit them? First, let's talk about what data culture, decision making, and embedded analytics have in common. Data is the new language of business, and a constantly growing amount of data is being produced and collected by companies. Data has become the center of decision making. And it is necessary to learn how to use data effectively in order to be and stay competitive, as well as to innovate successfully. Data culture is an approach where data plays a crucial role in the company. Quite literally, it means a shift in the mindset to focus on data, behaviors, beliefs, and practices that all contribute toward data-driven decisions. Today's competitive market environment requires making better decisions faster than ever before. The data supporting the discussion, companies' decisions are based on logic and facts instead of relying on good instinct and intuition. Basically, whenever you are about to make a decision, you need to know what happened, why did it happen, what is going to happen next, and how does it affect you. To be able to answer these questions, you need to have data about the situation and fit the data with the context. After that, you can make the decision of what to do next. In the best case scenario, you should strive to use data every time you are about to make a decision, even in your daily activities. But to incorporate data into a daily decision-making process, the data must be easily accessible and shareable. And that is where embedded analytics can help. What does embedded analytics actually mean? Embedded analytics, like any analytics, relies on charts and dashboards. The key difference is that embedded analytics does not look and act as a standalone solution. It is integrated into another application or web portal. With the term integration, I mean making one piece of software part of another. The data analytics, charts, graphs, or dashboards can become an integral part of your application without anybody noticing it originally comes from somewhere else. The end users can see only one piece of software. What is more, single sign-on ensures that they have access to data visualization embedded into another application without logging in to multiple tools. So, why should you use embedded analytics? And more importantly, how it can help you? There are three main benefits. The first one is customization. Embedded analytics, with its ability to be customized and branded, or themed if you like, can adapt the analytics to the context of the application and fit a wide range of needs. With the customization capabilities, you can pretty much get any result you imagine. It is very flexible and can closely match the branding of the software product from logo company, colors, and more. The second benefit is data-driven decision making. Bringing embedded analytics to a business processes gives the end user quick and easy access to data visualization within their daily workflow without the need to switch between multiple applications, for example, from their company portal to a separate data analytics application. End user can take immediate action based on the data from a specific insight displayed at the point of work. Therefore, the end user can get more value from the company's data and make data-driven decisions much more easily. The last benefit is reduced time. Except that, embedded analytics enables companies to fully integrate data analytics within their application without the need to invest time and money into developing their own solution from scratch. Who is Embedded Analytics for? Embedded Analytics allows companies to build scalable reporting for customers, business partners, as well as for internal teams. The ideal analytics platform is one that promotes self-service, making it suitable both for technical and non-technical users. Business users should be able to build their own reports using a drag-and-drop experience without the help of data specialists, while APIs are available for technical users. Not many people are aware that there are different ways to move dashboards and charts into another application. However, these different ways define a few fundamental questions. The first question is, what can developers achieve with the embedded analytics platform? Meaning, what are the results in terms of interactivity and the look and feel of the visualization or dashboard? Second question, how fast and developer-friendly is the implementation going to be? How long is it going to take, and what is the level of integration and flexibility? And lastly, what are the skill level requirements? Some of the methods are suitable for non-technical users more than others. When considering the above questions, we can distinguish between the following types of embedding: iframe, React SDK, and web components. React SDK has two subtypes: pre-built dashboards and visuals, and programmatic embedding. Let's have a look at each type, what are its capabilities, and what method is right for you. The first and probably best known method is iframe. It is the fastest and simplest method, but with limited integration and flexibility. The required skill level is low, which means that the majority users can manage it. You first build a dashboard in the analytics platform, and then you are ready to embed it. The process of embedding is like copy-pasting a paragraph into another document. You copy and paste an HTML snippet that represents a dashboard and paste it into your application or web page. It is worth noting that here you can embed only entire dashboards, not only individual visualizations. Even though this method is fast and simple, it has limited integration and flexibility, especially from the developer's perspective. The setting of the dashboard remains the same as it is on the platform. Without changing the setting in the analytics platform, you can't change the embedded dashboard. It's more or less a static solution that is not recommended for advanced customization or seamless integration. Also, the security level of the iframe might not comply with your security requirements. Despite the security risk being very low, other embedding methods guarantee a higher level of security. iframe is a good solution if you are looking to quickly enrich existing application with an analytical section and you don't need an advanced solution with deep integration. Here's an example of embedding with iframe. This picture shows a dashboard created in the analytics platform, ready for embedding. The second picture shows the embedded dashboard. You can see that the blue area is the dashboard that was moved to the application. Now let's move on to embedding with React SDK. It is a quick way of embedding, but with deeper integration and flexibility. It integrates the analytics with your application or web portal on a deeper level than via iframe. Dashboards and visualizations always become fully compatible with your application page. Why? The SDK is specifically designed to run in your environment. Therefore, you can affect how the dashboards and visualizations are rendered in the user interface. You are able to make some changes on the embedded dashboards and visuals separately from the dashboard in the analytics platform, and you can also set the visualization or dashboard to trigger an action in your application or web portal. With an SDK, there are two ways to embed visualizations. You can either use pre-built visualization and dashboards, or you can adjust and create new custom visualizations programmatically. We'll have a look at each method separately. First, we'll focus on embedding pre-built dashboards and visualizations. Embedding pre-built dashboards and visualization is a method enabled by using live components. This method requires a basic to intermediate level of technical skills. There's not much code needed, but some technical knowledge is required. With this method, you can embed both entire dashboards and single visualizations. The dashboards or visualization are built in the analytics platform just as in the case of iframe. However, the embedding itself is done via pre-built code provided by SDK. When it comes to the result of embedding with this method, there's not much difference for end users compared to iframe. In terms of interactivity and what they can see, it is very similar. However, the difference in terms of integration level and the level of flexibility for developers when embedding is significant. They have more flexibility in how to set dashboard. As already mentioned, developers can affect how the dashboard is going to be rendered. It means they can change the particular setting of the embedded dashboard, while the dashboard in the analytics platform remains unchanged. For example, you can edit the palette of colors or hide certain buttons, such as a PDF export button. The dashboard will be configured and customized according to the customer's needs, while the former dashboard will remain unchanged in the analytics platform for other purposes. Embedded visualization or dashboard can trigger an action in your application or web portal. The developer can code the level of integration so that the application may reflect changes happening in the embedded dashboard and the other way around. For example, you can apply filters in the dashboard. It may affect what information is going to be displayed on your website. For example, filtering countries in the dashboard will affect how many countries are going to be represented on the website. Even though the developer can code such a level of integration, the setting options are limited. There's a list of what can be coded and what actions can be defined. The developer can't code everything. This method is perfect when you need to embed the whole dashboard and visualization on a deeper level, but you don't have special requirements. Compared to iframe, this type allows you to put a visualization into a strategic position. What does it mean? Sometimes you don't need to have an overview of company data. It's useful to integrate just one visualization into your workflow. Visualization that displays specific information. For example, imagine the condition of the company's supply. Whenever the team notices a lack of any goods, they can order another supplies. And this is how you can make quick data-driven decisions based on your needs. Here's an example of embedded pre-built dashboard. In this picture, you can see a dashboard created in the analytics platform. React SDK will offer you a code that you copy and paste into your application. You can adjust some parameters, save it, and your dashboard is going to be embedded, just like you can see in this picture. The same way, you can embed a single visualization. First, you create a visualization in the analytics platform, just like you can see in the picture, and you can embed it into the visualization, like you can see in the second picture at the top right corner. Now let's have a look on programmatic embedding. Programmatic embedding is the most flexible embedding method, though it requires the most advanced technical skill levels. With this method, you can embed only individual visualization, no entire dashboard. Programmatic embedding offers two options, permanent components and raw data. Permanent components allows you to use templates of visualization provided by the analytics platform. You can adjust the visualization to your preferences via code provided by React SDK. However, you don't need to use templates of visualization all the time. You can even create a completely custom visualization by using raw data. To work with data, you can use React SDK, Python, or REST APIs. It allows you to easily manage the visualization characteristics completely via code and define the behavior from A to Z. With programmatic embedding, you work all the time only with code. You don't need to sign into the analytics platform at all. Programmatic way of embedding ensures native integration with the application. With this method, especially when you are working with raw data, you can build whatever you want. The visualization can have any shape you imagine and include any button you choose. Developers can code both the look and the behavior of the visualization, which means you can totally adapt the visualization to your application or website and create a context-aware visualization. The visualization can trigger an action in your application same way as with the previous method. However, when working with code, you can set any behavior. You are allowed to create as interactive visualization as you wish. There are no standard features since end users might interact with every feature the developer codes. There are no limitations such as in the case of pre-built dashboards and visuals. To sum it up, programmatic embedding is the right choice for anybody who needs to meet specific requirements. When using raw data, you can create a custom-made interactive data visualization and reach a high level of interactivity. Now, I'll show you an example of programmatic embedding. React SDK will provide you with a code snippet. By adjusting the snippet, you set the look and behavior of the visualization. And here, you can see an example of such a custom visualization. And in this picture, you can see the visualization already embedded. Lastly, I'll introduce you to quite a new method of embedding, and that is web components. This method combines the advantages of iframe and SDK pre-built dashboards and visuals. It is flexible and easy to set up at once. It stands in between iframe and embedding with SDK, as you can see in the illustration. The skill level is considered basic. When embedding with web components, you are going to work with minimum code. Web components are supported by all modern browsers natively, so you don't need to use any other ecosystem to be able to integrate the data analytics with your application. Compared to iframe, you can embed both entire dashboard and single visualization, just as in the case of SDK pre-built dashboards and visuals. As mentioned, also in terms of integration, it stands somewhere between iframe and SDK, again as you can see in the graph. It is much more flexible than iframe. Despite working with minimum code, the application can listen to the changes in the dashboard. However, it is still not as flexible as SDK since it has a lot of limitations. Web components is the right option if you don't want to use iframe due to its inflexibility and you want a solution with deeper integration that is easy to set up. With this method, you don't have to use any framework such as React, as you would have to use when embedding with SDK, and you can embed both visualization and dashboard. To sum it up, iframe is the easiest to set up method, but it is less flexible. On the other hand, programmatic embedding is considered the most flexible method despite being the hardest to set up. And web components is a simple but flexible method with slightly deeper integration and higher security than iframe. At the first sight, the result of analytics embedded with web components looks the same as with iframe or with SDK pre-built dashboards and visuals. That's why I'm not going to show you an example here. For the end users, the result is very similar. The difference is about the level of integration and flexibility for somebody who codes the solution. And which method is right for you? All of the embedded methods have their advantages and disadvantages. All of them are suitable for different use cases, and it depends on your goal, which is every time important to consider. Here are some questions that might help you to evaluate what method of embedding to choose. Do you need the analytics to be embedded in a week, month, or half of a year? What is the capability of your team? Do you rather need a method for technical beginners or advanced developers? Do you need to embed dashboard, visualization, or both? How flexible do you need the embedded analytics to be? Do you want to create dynamic and context-aware visualization? And do you have special requirements and need to create a custom visualization? All of the methods help you to access data analytics quickly and incorporate data into your daily decision-making process. The data-driven decision-making process will help you to avoid decisions based just on feeling and intuition. Thanks to that, the company can become more competitive in the market and improve business results. That's from me for today. Thank you very much for your attention, and if you would be interested to learn more, check out our websites. You'll find there more information about each method of embedding, including code examples. Thank you for your time and have a nice day.